Well, Jennifer, welcome to Philly. Welcome to our orchestra. And Nicole and I, it was important for us to meet you ahead of this really important week for us to have this fantastic piece performed again by the orchestra after way too much time,
yes.
Way too long. So maybe if you would start by introducing yourself so that our viewers know exactly what a fantastic person you are.
Oh, thank you. Well, I'm Jennifer Randolph. I am William Dawson's great niece. And so I'm excited when people are excited about his music, his contribution. He was amazing. He was incredibly inspiring. And I am more than excited to see what you do with this piece. No pressure.
I think it's very important for me as music director, but for everyone in the organization to look into the past of this orchestra and try to honor our past, because it's a very rich past, but some of it has remained famous. For example, we keep playing Rachmaninoff because it's part of our DNA and our past. But because that took such importance and we still should honor this, and we are, we overlooked some other really important moments of our past, especially under Leopold, Stokowski,
yes.
And Eugene Ormandy. Mm-hmm. And those conductors premiered a lot of pieces and commissioned a lot of composers. And one of those pieces that was premiered by the Philadelphia Orchestra is this Negro Folk Symphony by William Dawson. And so as part of our researches of repertoire, I came across this piece and just thought, well, this is a complete masterpiece from beginning to the end. And I think you brought some things. And I'm sorry to jump to this because I'm very excited.
The first piece I thought would be interesting was a passport that he used when he went to Africa.
Oh,
and was inspired by that. And we know that it was a tremendous influence and that he came back and that he was so inspired and that he had a chance to just hear and feel what was happening for him and experience stepping back in the context of your own history, mm-hmm. and to mm-hmm. bring back the best of that and to share it with what we term African American now, mm-hmm. Is incredible. And the fact that it's been forever since the entire piece has been performed. Then I brought the lapel pins that he would select to wear during performance, and offer you an opportunity if you are so interested in perhaps wearing one during the performance. I was told you might favor the bling there, you know, but...
Well, it would be such an honor. I have to say, this one is, they're all gorgeous. Maybe between this diamond or this pink one.
Yeah, yeah.
Because as you can tell, I love pink. And I think this is, but that would be very, very special for me. If you offer this to me and allow
absolutely.
Me, I definitely will.
I think
and
be
will
wonderful.
Feel hopefully that his spirit will
oh,
be
absolutely.
Even more
absolutely.
With all of us. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Oh my goodness.
I thought you'd really enjoy this one with the photograph of him with Stokowski when they are reviewing the symphony.
Wow.
I didn't know if you all had that in your archives.
What I do here, I'm the music librarian, so I'm basically the curator of all the sheet music. Uh-huh. And throughout my career, I've always been passionate about underrepresented composers, particularly people of color, people that look like me. Mm-hmm. And what I see in my job is that oftentimes gatekeeping happens in ways in which we don't know. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And sheet music is one of those things. I went to our friends at the Fleischer Collection here in Philadelphia, where they convinced the state and the government at large that it was of everyone's best interest to preserve the music of American composers. Mm-hmm. And so William Dawson submitted his score in 1940 for them to copy. Uh-huh. And they created this facsimile score.
Oh boy, here we
go. And a set of parts from that.
Oh my goodness, look at this. Oh,
please open it.
I'm almost afraid to move through the pages. Oh, wow.
Well.
Look at that. Dedicated to Dr. Leopold Stokowski. Isn't that amazing?
Oh.
First movement.
And a fun story before we move on here. As you see here in red, mm-hmm. you see there's a notation here that says the church bell should be about 17 inches in diameter and left free to ring when struck. From the original performance until now, there is a series of chimes mm-hmm. that ring. Mm-hmm. Those chimes are to symbolize the lives lost. Mm-hmm. to slavery in the transport from Africa
yeah.
oh, wow. to here. Mm-hmm. And you hear it in the original recording with Stokowski and the Philadelphia Orchestra, but after that, you don't hear it in any mm-hmm. other recording. So to see this here, and
written
those will be restored. We will hear those oh. in the performance.
That's amazing.
So I just wanted
gosh.
To bring that
note. Oh, look at that.
Note.
Oh.
This is going to inspire me also in my own studying.
This is just incredible. Thank you for sharing this.
Absolutely.
He was definitely a Renaissance man in terms of that interest in travel, incredibly self-taught. His father was not an overwhelming champion of education. Mm-hmm. He ran away because he wanted that education
yeah.
and worked hard in order to get that. He put his sisters through school. And my grandmother was one of those. She was a music teacher. She was a music major, so she followed in his footsteps.
Do you think, you know, that this was part of having to be, to stand up for himself so much in that time that he felt like he needed to be, and probably indicate to his family that one needed to be even better.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, think about his contemporaries, so W.E.B. Du Bois yeah. and other luminaries that are supreme historical figures within the Black community, and what they were trying to do to help Black people rise. And so he lived by example.
Mm-hmm.
I think that filtered in all the work that Black and brown people were doing at this time in terms of that need to be better than expected because of the times, very much so.
Well, I have to say that I'm amazed and maybe slightly disappointed that there's not more orchestral music,
yes.
you know, because the symphony is, you know, I haven't conducted it yet, so I'm still in the process of just this studying. But it's amazing the strong orchestration sense, you know, for it. And I'm sure that our audiences are going to be blown away by this piece.
It's amazing how many times he was able to go to Africa and to come back, and the impact on his music, the impact on how he structured what he called the Negro folk song instead of spirituals.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
The way that he was able to recreate sort of the sensibilities from Africa and how he wanted to bring that back and how it changed in terms of arrangements and moods that he was trying to create is incredible. So it'll be special.
Well, Jennifer, I can't tell you how special it is for you to be here. I feel that it's a very important moment for the history of our orchestra and for American music, and to feel your enthusiasm and knowledge, we feel definitely many steps closer to Dawson's music, and we will certainly, not only we look forward to it, but we really want everyone to experience the genius of your great uncle. And I can't wait to welcome you in the audience and hear your thoughts.
I cannot wait to see the magic that you're going to create. So it's going to be a really wonderful evening. Thank you.